Good afternoon, everybody. Like Frank said, this afternoon I would like to tell you a little bit about e-portfolios and the role e-portfolios can play in lifelong learning, the role they have there, and the values they can have for lifelong learning. And I will illustrate that by showing you the trailer e-portfolio. As we have developed for the same project. Before I move to the content of our portfolio, I want to very briefly introduce ourselves to allow you to get an idea of what our background and our expertise is. My name is Frans, like Frans said. Jose Jansson is present here, other colleagues are Anton and Hubert work on it, and of course we have other colleagues working on it. We are from the Center of Learning Societies and Technologies, that is a research institute of the Open University, and the same as Open University, and it's located in the Netherlands. The Open University is a distance teaching university. That means that we have a lot of experience in supporting lifelong learning. In the research institute, we have the several research programs. And the research programs we are engaged with is called the Learning Networks Program. And in the Learning Networks Program, we investigate learning networks. How should you set up a learning network to support lifelong learning? What's a learning network? Well, we define a learning network as an online network, and mainly consisting of people, of course also resources, but people learn from each other, learn together to support their lifelong learning. And mostly the non-formal or the informal part of the learning, although formal learning is also supported, but the focus is much more on the informal, non-formal learning, and that's why we bring our expertise into on the well, my introduction about the trailer project, I'm going to skip because it has been given. But in the trailer project, like Clara said, that mainly focuses on supporting informal learning. Why is informal learning that important? Because informal learning is a major part of lifelong learning. Now, what's lifelong learning? Everybody is engaging in lifelong learning nowadays. Not only because we're living in a knowledge society, which actually requires everybody to continuously update their knowledge, their competences, their skills, because everything is changing so rapidly in our society, but also because your professional life is changing. So not only for your profession, but also for your personal life, you automatically have to continuously update your knowledge, your skills, you have to, and you're continuously learning, as Clara already indicated. And often people don't even realize that they are learning, especially the informal learning. When you go to a course, of course you realize you're learning something. But the other types of learning, when you, in particular for, not even only for your job, but if you start a new hobby, you learn something, but you're not aware that you're learning context. And what we try to do with the trailer project is make people aware that there's a lot of informal learning going on, and that it has a value. And in particular in your professional life, there is additional value to show to others what your benefits are for informal learning. But you have to assist people to become aware of the informal learning and to help them show the result of the informal learning to others. So you have to make others aware of it. So, and how you do, the way you do that is usually by building your profile. And your profile that consists of information you write about yourself. When you go to an online community, you sign up, you fill in your profile. But your profile is much more than that. It is also all the activities you engage in. What do you do? What do you write? So, and you leave a trail. And the trail, particularly because a lot of the informal learning nowadays is happening online. So you have technology that can help you in constructing your profile. And that's what we try to facilitate with trailer portfolio. What the trailer portfolio does do is it helps you manage your learning activities, and by doing that also manages your competences, and then it helps you combine those, gather those, categorize those into showcases, so you can show that to others or for yourself even. I didn't want to show the live system, but always try to go to the live system, so I have created screenshots. I'm not sure how good the quality is back there. The trailer portfolio is one of the components where you manage your learning activities. Your learning activities, you can think of anything you have done, and particularly when you do it online. You can see, okay, when you are online, it is kind of bookmarking a site. And it can be a site you learn something from, or a site where you have published something. You want to, you can bookmark that. And then the tool sends that page to the portfolio. On the other hand, we also created a form for you to fill in. So when the activity is not online, you fill in a form and you describe what the activity is, maybe give a URL but or not, and that's also sent to the portfolio. So in the portfolio, you end up with a long list of learning activities you have done. When they're entered in the portfolio, you of course you always can edit them again. When you edit them, you get the form back, and you have several fields, and in one of the fields you describe the actual content of the learning activity. What did it consist of? Was it a page you read? Was it a seminar you attended? So you describe actually what you have done. You can provide a link to it, but you also describe what your comments about it. What did you learn from it? What were your feelings? And you then decide whether you want to keep this public or you want to make it keep it private or want to share that with your employer because of the other system in the trailer project. And of course, your activities you do to show what competences you have achieved. So you associate your learning activities with competences. And competences you can select from a catalog, from a list, or you just define them yourself. Then what the system then does do, your profile consists of what you fill in, and the dynamic part of activities. And you can construct that part yourself. But of course, we're online, we're using technology. The system also can store and record and track a lot of information about you and help you. What the portfolio does do is construct a list of competences from the learning activities. So you get also a list of competences. But it also allows you to enter competences yourself, for which, for example, before you started using the tool, you already said, okay, I'm already competent in this and this and this. You add that to this, so you don't have to associate it with learning activities. When you keep on developing those competences, you add those again here to the competences, so you can link them again. So you get a long list or short list of competences, and that for yourself an historical reflection of what activities you have done to achieve a supported competence. Of course, you're doing that for purpose. This even the recording of the learning activities already helps you make aware that you're learning. It helps you also become aware of the value of the learning. But very often you want them to group or categorize certain learning activities. Or, for example, when you want to show to somebody else what competencies you have achieved, you want to combine those. And then you're creating showcases. And showcase, you create a showcase usually for more than one purpose, or for several purposes. So you might have more than one showcase. So when you go for a job interview, you want to show your new employer what you have achieved. You create a showcase. When you get a new task, or you want to do a new project within your company, you say, okay, here I'm very good in the performance project. So you combine several activities. So from the list, when you create your showcase, you construct your profile. And your profile consists of the static part, just information about yourself, so your name, your photo, if you like to. You describe what this showcase is about, why you're constructing the showcase. And then you can select from your learning activities which ones you want to add to the showcase. And again, you can add some comments about those activities as well, why you enter them in the showcase. Like I said, you make this for a purpose, usually because you want to share that with someone else. But you can share this showcase either by sending somebody an email, exporting it to a PDF. So you can create an email message, send to somebody the link. And when that person then gets, when you share by having the system send an email, that person gets a hyperlink and can view the showcase online. And when they view it online, this is a view of what they see. They see your full showcase, but they also have the opportunity to add comments to your showcase. So they can add comments about the showcase as a whole, or they can add comments on individual learning activities. Because presentation had to be short, this is about all I have the opportunity to say about lifelong learning. The importance of lifelong learning, of course, is much more, but for now, I hope I have given you some impression of the value of portfolio, of helping you record what you've done, how that can help you realize the importance of your informal learning. Thank you.